Friends of yours, pussy ass motherfuckers used to wait for
They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I have it coming. If they freed me from this prison, if that room, I bet I'd move it on a little farther down the line, far from Folsom Prison. That's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
In a couple of spots I got round the quarry. No way, I'm just walking away and leaving all this to Sal. Right there's the first batch. Rig that one up, then we'll move on to the rest.
You weren't kidding about these explosives.
That's life in a quarry. Back in the day, we tried sticking our peckers in the ground and fucking the stone out, but all we ended up with was chapped nutsacks.
Let's see what's in this area here. So we're gonna blow this quarry sky high.
Got it.
They teach you that in the army?
Nope. Sunday school.
Back in the day, I'd have been out there fighting alongside of you.
Or going up against me.
That wouldn't have been good for you, son.
I told you that piece of shit Enzo would turn on you.
Take care of this.
Thank you.
So how is Vietnam, buddy?
If you consider shit on rice paddies beautiful, then grab your one-way ticket. Me and don't get up.
Some backup. My pal Vito says y'all are some bad motherfuckers.
Well, Vito ain't wrong. In fact, he's very, very right. I've got some time to give you a hand.
Okay.
Yeah, why wouldn't I be?
Said some of these men work for you.
Not some of them, all of them.
That should do it.
Car's through here.
God damn.
You like?
Nah, I love.
Get me there and I'll make a financial contribution to your cause. They got it blocked, but I bet we can bust through the gate.
What about the train tunnel?
The tunnel? It's your call. All aboard! Fuck you, you goddamn cockroaches!
Get the fuck out!
am I dropping you?
I got this girl, Henrietta. Shacks up at the Carousel Hotel in the Hollow. Smart as a fucking whip. I left a fucking bag with her. Should have all I need to get by.
Some tears in a bucket.
So, yeah, me and Sammy back in the day, we had these two knockouts. And we was drinking, partying, having the time of our lives. This was 1942. No, 43. He must have been about the age you are now. And the girl with your old man, she starts getting into the making out. But she got a problem. Sammy's passed out cold. Told you he was drunk off his ass. But this girl was into him, so she gives him the benefit of the doubt. Keeps trying, smacks him a bit, wakes him up. But every time she starts getting into it, Sammy drops. Poor bastard couldn't stay awake to save his fucking life. Finally, she's had enough and storms out of there, cursing the goddamn Blue Street. And do you know who that woman was?
Perla.
Perla. Jesus Christ, man. Perla didn't move to New Bordeaux until 44. I'll show you who it was. I got the photo right here.
Are you kidding me? Sammy had a shot with her.
She was passing through on her way to Hollywood. But it all worked out, didn't it? Sammy wound up with Perla. The love of his life. God damn, I miss those days. Fucking Sal. This is good right here. Sorry again about what happened to Sammy and Ellis.
Appreciate it.
Motherfucker, you look like the cat who ate the canary.
This is our first step toward breaking Marcano and taking over the city. I hear what y'all got to say, but I decide who gets the turf, and in the end, my decision is final.
Yeah, sure thing. I get it. But don't forget, my guys stepped up for you. They're working that hideout like it was already theirs. And it should stay that way.
Except for the tiny little detail that my men secured the other hideout. And we did it with a hell of a lot more style.
Until they to change your mind, lad. I can handle both rockets without any of the bitching these two got going on right now.
You gotta see all the angles, Lincoln.
You start dangling territory in front of me and then snatch it back. This agreement we had, it ain't gonna last.
What's the...
We got a long road ahead of us. Don't make the wrong first step, lad.
I'm towing the line, Lincoln. That's gotta mean something.
This.
It's never an easy answer, trust me, I know.
You and me, we have an understanding, right?
Don't Don't let some white boy rush you. Take your time.
So what's it gonna be, Chief?
I'll take the hit for 8,000. I'll sign it to you.
Gonna need Vito to run this turf.
About fucking time. Always knew you had a good head on your shoulders.
My men do what I tell them to do. Their loyalty is unmatched. But when you pull shit like this, that hurts me. Which in turn hurts you.
As for me, I'll be biding my time and waiting for one of you assholes to fuck up. Fair warning.
We're done for now. You'll hear from me if I need you.
I'm gonna put Cassandra in charge of the next one. And I need Burke. Vito's good. So, I'll take $8,000.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I thought. What a prick.
Turns out you were right.
I gotta go. Thank you for this.
Happy hunting, Donovan.
Miss Lancaster's helping me with a side project. You get a name at Enzo?
Yeah, Remy Duvall. He's not only building the casino, he also owns all the land where it's being built.
Remy Duvall? The jackass on the radio?
His family's been down here a couple hundred years. Thinks it makes him everyone's massa.
According to this, he heads up the Southern Union in his spare time.
The Southern Union's basically the fucking Klan. Right before I shipped out, Father James was with some other folks protesting the fact that the city didn't have any black cops. Southern Union came in and kicked the shit out of everybody they could get their hands on. Day after, they spray-painted God Hates Niggers across the front of his church.
If President Andrew Johnson had actually executed those traitorous fucks, we wouldn't have this goddamn problem.
Enzo also mentioned Olivia Marcano.
Olivia's an outlier. Old Southern money. She's the one that was married to Sal's brother, Lucho. At least until someone slit his throat.
And she runs Frisco Fields.
Ever since Lucho died. She expanded his drug business and opened a PCP lab. And since a lot of mafiosos live up there, she probably just has a place they can socialize.
Well, it's usually in the back of some business.
I never knew the mob had women as capos.
She's there to keep Duvall in line. Only people these entitled pricks listen to are other entitled pricks.
So who are you gonna go after first?
Duvall. Since he owns the land where the casino's being built, killing him will muddy things up.
You think hitting Olivia's businesses will help draw him out?
I've known racist assholes like him my entire life. Black man like me running around terrorizing white folks. He ain't gonna be able to let that stand. His pride will bring him down.
Hey, you know that bourbon's not cheap. Good luck out there.
Let me see. Before I go out, I need to change my outfit around.
I guess you were able to keep Burke sober long enough to get him on our side.
Okay, anybody else see my car? Okay, this one is there. We're gonna hit this one. Yeah.
How about sending some new wheels to Delray Hollow?
All that lot. Just getting her warmed up.
Don't run me over, son.
Here's your car, boss.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. Son of a biscuit eater. I screwed up on that one. I wasn't paying attention. I let the cop sneak up on me. He killed me. Wonder how much that cost me.
Could get a load of some of these tools. Some major train fixes and shit.
Don't know much about the French I took, but I do know that I love you. And I know that if you love me too, what a wonderful world this would be. Don't know much about geography. Don't know much of trigonometry.
We're gonna pause.